वेलकम टू डीसीई डिजिटल लर्निंग बीएससी थर्ड सेमेस्टर मैथमेटिक्स. इन दिस सेशन वी डिस्कस सीक्वेंस ऑफ रियल नंबर्स, दैट इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ रियल सीक्वेंसेस एंड बाउंडेड सीक्वेंसेस. फर्स्ट वी डिफाइन ए सीक्वेंस. ए सीक्वेंस इज ए फंक्शन हुज डोमेन इज द सेट एन ऑफ ऑल नेचुरल नंबर्स and the range may be any set S. Symbolically, it is denoted by F from N to S. In this mapping, N is the set of all natural numbers and S is any subset. Particularly, if this subset S is a subset of real numbers, then the sequence is called as a real sequence. That is, a real sequence is a function whose domain is the set N of all natural numbers and the range may be a subset of R of real numbers, and it is denoted as F from N to R, or it is also denoted by A from N to R. So this function is generally called as a real sequence. Instead of F, we represent it by small a. Now, the terms of a sequence. If A from N to R is a real sequence, the images of N belongs to capital N. That is, N belongs to natural numbers. What are the images of N belongs to natural numbers? Which are denoted by A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, so on. So, these images of natural numbers 1, 2, 3, so on, are called the elements of the real sequence or the terms of the real sequence. That is A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, so on, whose nth term is denoted by A of N, and so on. So those terms are called as elements of the real sequence. Those elements are denoted by A1, A2, A3, so on. The elements A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, so on are also denoted by A1, A2, A3, so on. So these terms are the elements of the sequence. The nth term of the sequence is denoted by An. So sequence na nth term annodu An anta represent maadthira. And the sequence is denoted by An within the flower brackets, or An between less than and greater than symbol. Remember, a sequence is denoted within the flower brackets. Flower brackets alli new An anna represent maadidira andra, it represents a sequence. Sometimes the sequence can also be denoted as Xn within the flower brackets. Instead of An, we may represent it as Xn. The terms of the sequence Xn are denoted by X1, X2, X3, so on. Now we take some examples of sequences. First one, An is equal to N within the flower brackets. Means, what is the sequence? We just put N equal to 1, N equal to 2, N equal to 3, so on. We get the sequence. So in the nth term, we put N equal to 1, we get the first term is 1. If you put N equal to 2, we get the second term, that is 2. If you put N equal to 3, third term 3, so on. So in An, we just put N equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, we get the sequence. Second example, An is equal to minus N. So here, what is the nth term? Minus N. Put N equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, we get the sequence minus 1, comma minus 2, comma minus 3, so on. Similarly, An is equal to 1 by N. Here, what is the nth term of the sequence? 1 by N. That is, An value is 1 by N. What are the terms of the sequence? If you put N equal to 1, 1 divided by 1. That is, first term is 1. If you put N equal to 2, 1 divided by 2, that is second term is 1 by 2. If you put N equal to 3, 1 divided by 3, third term is 1 by 3, so on. Like this, we can generate the sequence. Now, range of a sequence. What is mean by range of a sequence? The set of all distinct terms of a sequence is called its range without repetition. Distinct terms of the sequence is called as range of a sequence. Range may be finite or infinite set. Range annodu finite set adru agirbodu or infinite set adru agirbodu. Now we define a constant sequence. A sequence AN defined by AN is equal to K belongs to R for all N belongs to natural numbers, that is capital N, is called a constant sequence. Observe, generally the sequence is denoted by AN. Here AN represents the nth term. If that term is equal to some constant K belongs to real numbers, then that sequence is called as a constant sequence, because this K is independent of N. If you put N equal to 1, the value first term is K. If you put N equal to 2, K. N equal to 3, K. So on. Which means, if you put N equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, the value does not changes. That's why the sequence is called as a constant sequence. Particularly, if you take K is equal to 2, we get AN is equal to 2 comma 2 comma 2 comma so on. So this is an example of a constant sequence. Now we define bounded sequence. We define bounded sequence. A sequence AN is said to be bounded above if there exists a real number M, that is capital M, such that it satisfies the condition AN is less than or equal to M for all N belongs to capital N. So, when the sequence annodu bounded sequence aagbeku andre, definitely it must be a bounded above sequence and bounded below sequence. So, first we define bounded above sequence. A sequence AN is said to be bounded above if there exists a real number M such that AN is less than or equal to M for all N belongs to capital N. Which means every term of this sequence AN is always less than or equal to capital M. M annodu some real number. M is some real number. Each term of the sequence is less than or equal to M. Then the sequence is called as bounded above sequence. If you take an example, AN is equal to 1 by N. That is equal to 1 comma 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3 comma so on. We just put N equal to 1, 2, 3 so on. We get a sequence. Observe, in this sequence, every element is always less than or equal to 1. This sequence is the element. If you take any element, here we have infinite number of elements. If you take any element, always that element is either less than or equal to 1. So, is a bounded above sequence, because AN is always less than or equal to 1 for all N belongs to capital N. Andre, this sequence alli iruvanta ella elements unu less than 1 agirutte illa equal to 1 agirutte. That's why this sequence is called as bounded above sequence. Observe, this sequence satisfies this condition. AN is less than or equal to M anno condition na satisfy maadta ide. Particularly, what is the value of capital M? In this sequence, the value of capital M is 1. Next, bounded below sequence. A sequence AN is said to be bounded below if there exists a real number M, small m, such that AN is greater than or equal to small m for all N belongs to capital N. This is exactly opposite to bounded above sequence. Bounded below annodu opposite ide. Observe maadi, bounded above annodu AN is less than or equal to M. Here bounded below means AN is greater than or equal to M, small m. Any sequence satisfying this condition, AN is greater than or equal to M for all N belongs to capital M, is called as bounded below sequence. If you take an example, AN is equal to n within the flower brackets. What are the terms of that sequence? 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, so on. Observe this sequence. Each term of the sequence is always greater than or equal to 1. This sequence alli iruvanta ella terms unu greater than or equal to 1 agide. Is a bounded below sequence. The sequence is a bounded below sequence because an is greater than or equal to 1 for all n belongs to capital N. Andre an annodu general term agirutte ee sequence alli, which means we may take n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, so on. So every term of that sequence is definitely greater than or equal to 1. ಈ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತ ಯಾವುದೇ ಟರ್ಮ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಆ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಒನ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ದಿಸ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಬಿಲೋ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್. ನೌ ವಿ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಎ ಬೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್. ಎ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಬೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೋತ್ ಬೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಎಬೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಬೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಬಿಲೋ. ಎ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಈಸ್ bounded above as well as bounded below, then the sequence is called as bounded sequence, or it is also defined by a sequence an is said to be bounded if there exist two real numbers small m and capital M such that an is greater than or equal to small m, less than or equal to capital M for all n belongs to capital N, which means every term of the sequence is always greater than or equal to some real number, less than or equal to some real number, then the sequence is called as a bounded sequence. If you take an example, an is equal to 1 by n. What are the terms? 1, comma 1 by 2, comma 1 by 3, so on. Is a bounded sequence because an is greater than or equal to 0. Less than or equal to 1 for all n belongs to capital N, which means ee sequence alli iruvanta ella elements na observe maadi, definitely every element of the sequence is greater than 0. Ee sequence alli iruvanta ella elements nu 0 ginta jaasti irutte, adhe tara 1 ginta kadame irutte, equal to 1 or less than 1 aagirutte. If you take any element belongs to this sequence, definitely that element is either greater than 0 or less than or equal to 1. So that's why this sequence is called as a bounded sequence. Now we define unbounded sequences. Unbounded sequences means which is not bounded. So there are three types of unbounded sequences. A sequence an is said to be unbounded above if it is not bounded above. Unbounded above yavaga agutte, it is not bounded above. For example, an is equal to 2n, that is equal to 2 comma 4 comma 6, so on. Definitely it is unbounded above sequence because there exists no real number capital M such that an is less than or equal to capital M for all n belongs to capital N. Here if you choose any value for capital M, definitely there is an element belongs to the sequence, that element is not less than or equal to capital M, that's why this sequence is unbounded above sequence. Ee sequence alli iruvanta ee M ge neevu ene number choose maadi, real number, choose any real number for M, definitely there is an element belongs to this sequence, that element is definitely less than, not less than or equal to M agirutte. That's why this sequence is unbounded above sequence. Next, a sequence an is said to be unbounded below if it is not bounded below. A sequence is not bounded below, then it is called as unbounded below sequence. For example, take same sequence with a negative sign, an is equal to minus 2n, that is equal to minus 2 comma minus 4 comma minus 6, so on. It is unbounded below sequence because there exists no real number small m such that an is greater than or equal to m for all n belongs to capital N. Here we choose any number for small m, definitely there is an element belongs to this sequence, that element is not greater than or equal to small m agirutha. That's why this sequence is not bounded below sequence, or it is also called as unbounded below sequence. Next, a sequence AN is said to be unbounded sequence if it is not bounded. A sequence which is not bounded sequence is called as unbounded sequence. For example, AN is equal to minus 1 power n into n. If you put n equal to 1, we get minus 1. In this nth term, put n equal to 1, we get minus 1. If you put n equal to 2, we get plus 2. N equal to 3, minus 3. N equal to 4, plus 4, so on. Definitely this sequence is unbounded sequence, because there exist no real numbers small m and capital M satisfying the condition AN is greater than or equal to small m, less than or equal to capital M, for all n belongs to N. Right? This sequence alli small m and capital M annodanna neevu yavade real number na choose maadi, definitely there is some elements belongs to this sequence which does not satisfy this condition. That's why this sequence is called as unbounded sequence. Now we solve some problems related to sequences. Write the first 5 terms of the infinite sequence with general term an is equal to 2n plus 1. So here given the general term of the sequence, by using this general term we write the first 5 terms of the sequence. Just consider the general term and put n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, n equal to 4 and n equal to 5. We get the first 5 terms of the sequence. If you put n equal to 1, we get first term which is denoted by a1 is equal to 2 into 1 plus 1 equal to 3. Similarly, a2, that is second term, a3, third term, a4, fourth term, a5, fifth term, that is 11. Now what is the sequence? An is equal to 2n plus 1, nth term, that is equal to, what are the terms of the sequence? 3 comma, 5 comma, 7 comma, so on. Next problem, check whether the sequence an is equal to 1 plus 1 by n is bounded or not. So how to check the sequence is bounded or not? We just find the values of small m and capital M such that it satisfies the condition an is greater than or equal to small m and less than or equal to capital M for all n belongs to capital N. So first consider the sequence and put n equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, we get the terms of the sequence, that is 1, comma 3 by 2, comma 4 by 3, comma so on. Observe this sequence. Definitely, each term of the sequence is less than or equal to 2. Observe maadi, ee sequence alli iruvanta ella elements unu less than or equal to 2 agirutte. 1 definitely less than 2. 3 by 2. Definitely less than 2. 4 by 3, definitely less than 2. So each term of this sequence is less than or equal to 2 agide. And also each term of this sequence is greater than or equal to 1 agide. This sequence alli iruvanta ella terms unu less than or equal to 2 ide, greater than or equal to 1 ide, which means small m value is 1 and capital M value is 2. So adanne na will express maadiru. Every element of a sequence is less than or equal to 2. Further, each element, that is every element, is greater than or equal to 1. That is, an is greater than or equal to 1, less than or equal to 2, for all n belongs to capital N. E sequence alli iruvanta ella elements unu greater than or equal to 1 ide, or less than or equal to 2 agirodrinda, this sequence is called as a bounded sequence. Similarly, This is also an example of bounded sequence. In this sequence, what is the small m value? 0. Each element of this sequence is greater than 0 and each element of this sequence is less than or equal to 1. That's why the sequence 1 by n is a bounded sequence, because each term, that is 1 by n, it can also be denoted by an. An is greater than 0 and less than or equal to 1. That's why this sequence is called as a bounded sequence. Next problem. Check whether the sequence an is equal to minus 1 power n into n is bounded or not. So consider the sequence. Ili xn, an place alli xn ide. Sequence can also be represented by an or xn. So nth term of the sequence is xn here. If you put n equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, we get the elements or terms of the sequence. What are the terms of the sequence? Minus 1, plus 2, minus 3, plus 4, minus 5, so on. So here if you observe, if you choose any real number for small m and capital M, definitely those real numbers does not satisfy this relation. Xn is greater than or equal to small m, less than or equal to capital M, for all n belongs to capital N. Suppose if I choose m value is minus 100, small m value, and capital M value is plus 100. If I choose small m is minus 100 and capital M is plus 100, definitely there is an element belongs to this sequence. This sequence alli yellow ond kade nimge ond element irutte. That element is greater than minus 100. That element is greater than minus 100 and less than or equal to plus 100. That's why this sequence is unbounded sequence, or it is also called as not a bounded sequence. Thank you.